Bringing news this evening, in an unprecedented move, the Guam Education Board late last night, and after nearly 10 hours of deliberation, voted to terminate Superintendent John Fernandez's contract. PNC's Rebecca Elmore sat down with Board Chairwoman Lucy Nicholas, and she files this report.
It's been known that GDOE Superintendent John Fernandez is well-loved in the education community. He's popular with the youth and even active on social media. So when news broke that the Guam Education Board voted to terminate his contract, the community was shocked. The decision came after the board spent nearly 10 hours over a period of 2 days in executive session to decide what kind of action to take on GDOE Superintendent John Fernandez. PNC met with Board Chairwoman Lucy Nicholas, who explains what happened.
Last night we spent long hours revisiting again the content on the report, clarifying other issues that may not have been thought of in our previous executive session. Then we discussed every individual board member was able to give their own insights, their thoughts about what they have read in the report, what they have heard in terms of every board member being given an opportunity to ask questions and get answers on their questions, either from a board member or from our legal counsel.
According to San Nicolas, the whole report focused on potential Title IX violations. Title IX governs gender discrimination and sexual harassment in the workplace. San Nicolas says the report also references local statutes and board policy. The investigation was opened as a result of a complaint filed by an 18-year-old J.P. Torres student, says Fernandez sent her a sexually suggestive text message in August of last year. The Board of Education hired an independent attorney to look into the claims. However, San Nicolas admitted that the board's decision to terminate Fernandez's contract was not entirely based on the student's allegations.
Was there any information or testimony or allegations included in the final report that was not directly related to the J.P. Torres student's accusations?
There may be some that were not directly related to the original situation. However, the relationship links in to the Title IX.
According to San Nicolas, the next steps for the board include waiting for the legal counsel to prepare the bill of particulars, which will identify what standards were used to base their decision. And then from there, the communication from their legal counsel, attorney Gary Gumatautau, who's expected to confer with Fernandez's legal counsel, attorney David Lujan.
I believe the next step would be to announce that the position is open to interested people that feel that they are qualified for the position.
PNC contacted both Fernandez and his attorney David Lujan for comment, but they did not return our calls as of news time. For PNC's News First, I'm Rebecca Elmore.